Hey guys, Amandu here and welcome back to my channel. I am still a little sick, you can probably tell by my voice, but I'm feeling a lot better. My throat is still a little sore and it's kinda clogged, but hey, at least I can breathe better now, so I consider it a win. For today's video, I wanted to share with you the process I did of a tattoo design, or something I conceived as a tattoo design. I am extremely happy with this piece. I started the sketch as kind of a warm-up exercise, but I really liked it, and I started working on it a little more and a little more, you know, by adding the flowers, which I think are a very nice touch, and adding these different branches, adding, you know, some texture to the hair, and the more I worked on it, the more I really liked it. And this got me thinking about how sometimes you really like the things you do, and this is one of those times. One of those times where I wasn't trying so hard, and yet the result is something that I am so incredibly proud of, something I really, really, really love. And when you actually sit down and try to make something you can be proud of, you end up with things you don't like. No, I am not a psychologist or a psychiatrist or anything, so I don't know how going into drawing with certain mentality can affect the way you draw. I do know that the more relaxed I am and the easier I go on a piece, the more I enjoy it, the better the result is. And that's something that's hard for me to do, having anxiety and all of that, because I am always so self-conscious of what I'm doing. I'm always, oh, should I really be making this line? Oh, should I really be doing this? Should I really be doing that? Did I just mess it up? Will I mess it up with the next line, with the next brush, with the next, you know, just idea that comes into my head? Am I messing everything up? And sometimes those voices and those comments that are happening in your head are so loud that you can't stop hearing them. You can't stop hearing yourself just asking yourself these questions like, am I messing it up? Am I doing this right? Is this what I wanted to do? And yet every now and then, my mind is clear and I get to do things like this where it may not be perfect, but it looks exactly like what I pictured in my head. And if maybe not exactly, but really close to what I pictured in my head. And that is so incredibly satisfying. I don't get that satisfaction that often because of my anxiety, but when I get it, I really start thinking, what do I need to do to achieve this feeling more often? And it's a very hard question to answer. Is it a matter of my mental health? Is it a matter of my medication? Is it a matter of how I start a sketch? Is it a matter of how I finish that sketch? There are so many variables that I don't know, or I haven't gotten to the point where I can just find a process that leads me to that. And you know, that sucks, because it would be so easy to just isolate these things and every time, you know, as much as possible, create a scenario that is similar to it and just conceive every work of art in the same idyllic circumstances. But that's just impossible to do, and the more you try to do it, the more you realize it's not going to happen. You know, the more you sit down and the more you think about it, the weirder it gets, and it's more and more complicated, but it is also entertaining to me. And I don't know, this being a complete artist means that you can learn and continue to learn how to control these variables in your environment, and you learn to work every day with the best mindset, and you develop a process where you can always have this good mindset and just continue moving forward. I think my biggest issue is that my anxiety makes me overconscious of what these things are and when I'm doing them wrong. And it's probably a matter of me also trying to let that go. I have a very hard time letting go of things, especially things that I do wrong, because I tend to focus so much on the things I do wrong, because I think that's what defines me, not my success. And in a way, it's true that you learn more from failure than from success. But one thing is to consider failure as this positive outcome of learning, and a completely different thing is to just focus on what's negative and tell yourself that you just keep failing and you're never gonna be able to do what you want to do. So that is a mindset that I struggle with a lot, and maybe a lot of people struggle with. And maybe a lot of people have found the way or found the process and find a way to just forget about all of that and forget about the worries and build a situation every day in which they can produce the art they want and judge it after, not during the process. Just let it flow organically. I am not there yet with my process, though it's getting better and better every day, so I'm hoping I will be there very soon. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you have any tips on how to build a healthy work environment for an artist, please let them in the comments down below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel for more videos like this, and I will see you next time. Stay creative, guys. Bye bye. Of your heartbeat.